Researchers in Pittsburgh tell me there could be a huge breakthrough in the treatment of cancer. It's a vaccine, and it's showing dramatic results for those in the trials. So dramatic, in fact, one expert says at first it seemed too good to be true. But the results are holding, and soon it could change cancer treatment.
Researchers appear to be on the verge of unlocking a new vaccine for cancer.
We're all quite excited based on the preliminary data that this really could be a tipping point.
Part of that work is happening now at the Hillman Cancer Center. And within a year, it could change the way cancer is treated. The final phase of the Moderna vaccine trial is now being tested globally, targeting melanoma or skin cancer. But researchers are confident it will work the same for all cancers. Dr. Jason Luke, the director of UPMC's Immunotherapy and Drug Development Center, is on the steering committee for this trial. He says it's showing incredible results. For people who have cancer, doctors would take a sample of that cancer and concoct a personalized vaccine based on that specific cancer and that particular patient. So every patient's vaccine would be different.
For example, your vaccine would be completely different than my vaccine. And that's a very exciting and it's a very big change from the way we thought about vaccination for the past several decades.
It could not be used to prevent cancer, but when early cancer is found, the vaccine would teach the body's immune response to prevent it from coming back or spreading. It uses the mRNA vaccine, which is the very same technology first used for the COVID vaccine.
Well, I think everyone was actually quite surprised. The quality, the level of evidence that came out of the phase two clinical trial. For context, we've never seen a clinical trial where adding another drug to the immunotherapy after surgery made a difference. This is the first trial, and there have been a few that were failed trials. So not only did it show a difference, like an improvement to the regular immunotherapy, it doubled the outcomes. It improved it by double. We've never seen anything like that.
There are several other companies testing out these mRNA types of vaccines for breast, brain, colon, and pancreatic cancers.
So when those data came forward, they're almost too good to be true. So many of us are cautiously optimistic that we're on the precipice of what is going to be a transformational change in the way we think about treating cancer after surgery.
So exciting, and so much of the work being done here in Pittsburgh. Now, although the technology came about because of the COVID vaccines, Dr. Luke says they're calling this an individualized neoantigen therapy because he realizes that some people have a negative connotation to the word vaccine. But it really could make a big difference.
And in terms of timelines, you're looking at about a year from now?
Can you believe that? Yeah, as soon as a year, the final trials are happening right now, the phase three trials. But the results are so powerful, he said, it could be approved before the end of the trials.
I know, Michelle, you've been telling us UPMC is also working on a vaccine specifically for breast cancer. Any update on how that's going?
Oh, I ask. Yeah. I can't wait to find out about that. They said there should be an update soon. So we are eagerly awaiting that, the same kind of technology, but hopefully we'll announce that shortly.
I hadn't heard of any of this, so this is really eye-opening.
It's fascinating.
Yeah, great story. Thank you. Let's get over to Ashley for more.